When the four Vedas remained drowned in the sea, Lord Srihari in the form of a fish saved the four his creation according to Indian Puranas. Matsyavatara. When earth was bitter or amrit, Goddess Lakshmi Airavatam appears that can get out of water and survive on land too. It developed an armor on its back and strong legs for its survival. Varahavatara is supposed to have saved the planet earth through the whole earth and threw it into the sea. Hari retrieves the earth and carries it on his tusks out of the water. The amphibious life form evolved further and developed tusks, longer legs and a snout for foraging for food, transforming itself into a complete landform, that is, the boar and other land fortifications to facilitate hunting and creeping with four legs modified into arms. This form is unique and depicts beautifully the transformation of beast into human. Hiran, and it was time for Srihari to restore peace to the world. Due to the boon that he obtained, he could not be killed by either devas or humans. So, Srihari took the form of a half-human and half-beast and appeared out of a pillar and killed him during the time of twilight and preserved Dharma in the form of Prahlada and its Puranic reference. One better features. King Bali conquered the three lokas and ruled people in the best possible way. Yet, he left the devatas high and dry, without any power, and they requested Lord Hari to eliminate him. When Bali offers 3 feet land in arms to Vamana, he succeeds in pushing Bali to Patala and saves the universe from the monopolistic clutches of King Bali. This Vamana is the dwarf form of humans, which resulted from further evolution of the beast into a complete human form. It represents the early man in the theory of evolution. In this stage, early man invented small things like Kshatriyas who had overstepped the limits of decency and good conduct and had become a menace to all righteous life. He raged around the world 21 times like a fierce fire and destroyed the Kshatriya race with his invincible axe called the Parsu to hand over the earth to a softer Prajapati according to Puranas. Early man continued his hunter-gatherer habits. He was strong, fierce and wielded a weapon, the axe, to clear the forest and settle at a place. The stage of advancement of man matches with the Puranic Parasurama Avatara. Rama Avatara. This is unique again and a milestone in the sense that it was meant for providing a role model for the human beings as an ideal son, husband, brother, king, friend and foe as well. Thus, man evolves into a more civilized and sophisticated ways to protect his property. Balarama Avatara. Bhargava Purana describes Balarama as Krishna's very first divine expansion. Balarama killed demons like Dhenukasura and Pralamba. When once Pralamba was heavier and heavier, unable to bear the weight, the demon assumes his original form of a cloud and Balarama kills him by splitting his head. He started misinterpreting the Vedas and resorted to sacrificing animals as well as humans during yajnas. Buddha tried to wean them away by preaching non-violence and established peace on earth. This avatara in its evolutionary phase indicates the intellectual development of humans to a higher level. Kalki avatara. He shall come to destroy the wicked, to restart the new creation and to restore purity of conduct to people's lives.
Thank you. Yeah. Very, very, very proud moment for us. We are celebrating the annual day at the Presidential School at Swarna Bharati Stadium. It's our 27th edition of our annual day. The school has two curriculums, CBSE and State Board. The inception of this beautiful moment started in 1994. And also we are facilitating we have over 1,000 students who are participating today. And we are also facilitating our school topper, who is also the India topper, who got 500 out of 500 in the CBSE board examinations. She not only makes the school proud, also the state proud and the country proud.